The mic is not my therapist chair, and emotions can help me build consensus there, but not always around the point I'm trying to make. So, I'll be calm, I'll be quiet, I'll be peaceful. I'm not so damaged as you think I am. In fact, I am proud of my emotional awareness. It helps me connect to you, so let me prove how aware I am by shape-shifting and fitting into a box more familiar. Let me meet your expectations. And I did. And I stopped writing. I stopped looking for answers until dawn breaks. I stopped daydreaming to make up for the nights I spun awake, and I stopped asking questions. Like, why at the same time that it's so hard to look back, do we refuse to let go of the past? And why do we think the past is a reflection of the future? And what are the answers echoing in our souls that make us so afraid of these questions? Please, I won't ask any more questions if you just stop yelling. I'll tell you what you want to hear. Please stop yelling. Please stop. I'm telling you what you want to hear. And after a while, it didn't hurt anymore. This is life, I learned. I had stepped into that box. I told myself I had it coming. I told myself I had it coming. Because it takes a certain kind of courage to name your wounds out loud. But who will care to listen? That's not pleasant. Choose something productive. You're talking too much. You're too loud. You're too much. Not Iranian or feminine enough. And after a while, I found the box I was meant to be in, something more educated, something I didn't have to feel to breathe in. But in East Boston, my student Daniel, he didn't trust his teachers, and Rochelle's shoulders whispered apologies for her dark features, and Anna had scars and bruises from her mom, and DeAndre's dad couldn't stay clean, so he's up in Salem, and now I ask them, what's your family income? Your race? What kind of grades do you make? Who do you live with? And he tells me, she's my brother's grandma, my half-brother. No, she's not mine. Yes, my mom stops by. Is it public housing? That sounds fine. And I check the appropriate boxes to help them get what they have coming, while Sister Harriet in the library uses boxes to display slavery by another name and other stories of identity and shame. It's buried behind our consciousness, our fear of challenging, our fear of change. But deeper still in our histories are the seeds of our voices, our identities, our true selves that live, feel, and breathe unapologetically. My spiritual ancestors walked through the streets of Iran with burning candles lodged into their flesh by their enemies. The bastinado made roses blossom on the soles of their feet, so everywhere they walked, they left bright crimson flower petals. And today, my distant relatives are in prison for their beliefs, for educating their children in a university run out of basements by their own scholars and using textbooks smuggled in by some of us from the outside. My first generation Iranian brothers and sisters, we could have been living that, so am I not Iranian enough to you? Do I have to keep speaking in allusions to the Underground Railroad, today's ghetto, to justify my decisions? What do Iranian, feminine, educated mean to you? Am I speaking the truth? Am I still telling you what you want to hear? Now, what box have you put me in? Do I fit? Is my pain legitimate to you? If not, okay, maybe it's fake to me too, just a way to get you to listen.